हेलो
नाउ आई कैन ऐड पीपल राइट कैन ऐड ऑल आई एम एडिंग ऑल
यू कैन ऐड सर प्लीज सर हु द नेम ऑफ प्रिंसिपल सर
डॉक्टर जी आर परवान डॉक्टर जी आर परवान इट विल सी नेम डॉक्टर जी आर गणपत भाई परवान
அதனியே பார்த்துக்கோ
सर प्लीज
अनम्यूट 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 पाठक साहब अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ पाठक साहब हेलो पाठक साहब
या ऑलरेडी आई अनम्यूटेड
ओके 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 नाउ आई थिंक दैट वी शुड स्टार्ट राइट
यस प्लीज
So welcome, Government Arts and Commerce College, Netrang. Welcomes you all in our 41st webinar on cyber security, the need of the hour for New India. And our guest is now Dr. Chintan T. Pathak. He is an expert in cyber law, and he is also technocrat. He is also educator, and he is known for ethical hacking. And he will talk us. He will address us how to save ourselves from hacking, how to save ourselves from being cheated by the cyber world, right? So cyber security, the current issue, it is now the need of the hour. It is a burning issue that people are cheated now, right? Someone's ATM is hacked, someone's you can say account is hacked. So in the world of cyber land, or in the world of internet, everything is possible. Someone can hack your account, someone can cheat you, someone can loot your bank account. So without wasting my time, I would warmly welcome Dr. Chintan Pathak on behalf of my college, on behalf of my principal Dr. G.R. Parmar, and on behalf of my team, I welcome you, Dr. Chintan Pathak. I also welcome my dear participants. You have made us a grant. This is a grand, great event where 700 people have registered. We have to close that link. See, just within 24 hours, we got more than 700 registered participants. So thank you, India. Thank you all, sir. Welcome you. And please start your address.
Just please make me host for. Now I'm host.
Yes, you're host. All the participants are requested to mute your audio.
My screen is visible now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So first of all, I am really thankful to the Dr. B.R. Parmar sir. Jaswan Rathore sir, the technical person Mr. Tanvir Rahmat, and all the members of the Government Arts and Commerce College of Netrang. Actually, really, I'm really surprised to know that they are arranging this 41th webinar. I think this is the highest webinar all over the India, and I'm really congratulate the whole team of the Netrang for doing such a wonderful job for the nation. And I observe from the very first webinar, maybe I was there, and they are keep arranging a different kind of subject which are exactly need of the hour. Now the today's subject is also one of the very important as far as the our daily life is concerned, because see that cyber security is not a choice. I always used to say that cyber security is not a choice, it's a habit. And particularly after the post COVID, there are number of things we learn and our life is completely going to be changed. So we need to be understand how the technology work and what are the pros and cons of the technology. Now, before starting my session, I just want to like a small player that Om Astoma Sad Gamaya Tamsoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrutyoma Amrutam Gamaya Om Shanti 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 Om. Keep me not to the phenomenal world of the reality, but make me go towards the reality of eternal self. Keep me not in the ignorant state of darkness, but make me go towards the light of the spiritual knowledge. Keep me not to the world of mortality, but make me go towards the world of immortality. Om peace, peace, peace. So this particular session is going to be dedicated to all those persons who are victimized in the COVID-19. And I pray to the God that they are going to, their family is going to be safe and they are peacefully living their life. So I would like to start with the very small thing, maybe that you see this picture. Now, please check in the chat window, please tell me what exactly you believe with this picture. How you analyze this picture? Just quickly put your review in the chat box, what they mean to say. I just try to know that what you understand from this picture. So this is a right now a scenario maybe that that particularly person says that I am using you because you are free, and the technology also said the same time that I am using you because you are free. Now in the COVID-19 we all are free because we are not that kind of work, we are not supposed to go outside due to the lockdown. And this is, I think, a first unlock one is going to be a start. So in this scenario, maybe that you understand this picture saying that right now, whatever we are doing is we are not actually knowing the technology. The picture already derived that if you are not aware about the technology, ultimately technology is going to be use you. And that's I want to see you in my whole session. And how can we protect ourselves from this kind of thing? I'm not saying that the technology is a bad thing, but I am saying only this thing, that you need to be very careful whenever you are using any kind of technology. And that's the main point. Now the today's topic is cyber security need of the hour for New India. And for that, we need to be, first of all, understand that what is exactly what is the New India concept. So maybe that you see in the screen that the New India concept is a particular our 2007 to 2020 projection said that the India free from poverty, corruption, terrorism, and all these things until the entire country adopting a good governance. Now that is what exactly mentioning is that, and governance with the technology. Now the technology world is a very, very important, because it is also mentioned that under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, about 57 crore have we are saved from the for the ongoing scheme by adopting good governance and technology. Now previously what happened that there are a lot of expenses are going on, and we all know that amount should not go to the needy person, and that's why the technology play a vital role in this scenario. And after that you understand that our Honorable Prime Minister also encouraged that the Digital India, because that the corruption is a major part in the whole system, and with the technology help we can just transparent our system. And right now we already observe that due to the Aadhaar card, and there are due to the Jan Dhan Yojana, and there are different kind of schemes, all the beneficiary get their benefit directly to their account. Now it is a really a very, very positive side of the technology, and that's why all over the world now all the world, basically we are a developing country, but the world is basically looking towards the India, because India is a great economy, the great manpower, as well as the great brain also all over the world. Now the same time our Honorable Prime Minister introduced, because right now what we are talking on the Zoom, it is due to the technological advancement, and that we adopted technology in the previously 5-7 years back. Because right now we are doing some banking and everything on the online, we are paying our thing on the online, because due to the digitalization of the India. And that is what our Honorable Prime Minister said. And in the 2012, I remember the speech in the 2012 in one of the summits, our Prime Minister said that I dream of Digital India. And why the dream of Digital India? Because if you are digitally empowered, our economy, your governance, then it will create a great value, transparent, And that's why the Digital India Initiative seeks to lay emphasis on e-governance and transform India, digitally empowered society. It is also ensure the government services are available to the electronically to transform CA doing a business in the country. And that is a real, very important part that all the business is going to transform. Now all the one-way system is also going on. With the same time, we also understand what are the 9 pillars of the Digital India. Now the 9 pillars of the Digital India is particularly broadband highway, accessibility, public internet connection, e-governance, e-kranti, information security, electronics manufacturing. All these are the 9 pillars of the Digital India, and that our government aggressively working on that. But this is a scenario right now. We as an educated person, I believe that most of them are the coming from the academic background. So it is our moral responsibility that we need to be understand technology first, and we are supposed to share all these things with our students as well as the different people who come across to our contact. Now, if I want to see, if I want to go further, so my question is to you that how many you are downloaded free product on internet? Just quickly send your response. How many you are downloaded free product on internet? Quickly share your response, please. I put an example like software, apps, songs, movies. So there are a lot of stuff right now that we are downloading on the internet. In particular, this lockdown period, of course, that we use internet more than we regularly use, right? So if suppose that we are using internet for 2 or 3 hours, in lockdown duration, we use internet almost 8 to 9 hours. It's 3 or 2 times or 4 times more that we previously used. Now, for whatever we are downloading on the internet, these are the products, right? But for those particular software or any app developer or any song particular website, they are making us as a product. Maybe you understand what I mean to say that we are downloading product. We are downloading those products because they are free, right? And for that particular, we are using those products because free. But at the same time, those particular applications, songs, or whatever the platform, they are use us as a product. And when I am saying that we are used as a product, it means that there is nothing like a free lunch in this world. And particularly on the internet, there is nothing like a free thing. And that is very clearly mentioned, because whenever you are downloading such a free things on the internet, at the same time, your data is going to be compromised. Your privacy is going to be compromised. And anyone can use your data. Anyone can use your details without your knowledge. Particularly, I would like to draw the kind attention all of you that I had one question again then to you, that right now, how many applications in your mobile phone? Maybe you can quickly type on the chat window, maybe 10, 15, 40, 60, 100, whatever application, you can quickly type on the chat window, how many applications right now in your phone? If you already typed that I supposed to believe, or I'm saying that whatever application, whatever number you're typing is completely wrong. And when I'm telling it's completely wrong, it means that you never try to know, or you don't know right now how many applications in your phone. So at the same time, when you are not knowing that how many products in your phone, it is clearly thing that we are not knowing. So I request that all participants mute their mic, please. I request all the participants to mute their mic, please. So ultimately, what happened that whatever application you are downloading from the internet, of course, that your friend suggests you, or maybe somebody suggests you, or maybe somebody give you a reference of the application. The application is asking certain kind of thing to you, and that those are the certain permissions. The permission is basically from the access your microphone, to access your camera, to access your data, your contact, your SD card data, your media files. So everything they are asking, and particularly we are just allowing all this thing, and ultimately we are going over each and every detail to that particular application developer. And that's why it is really a very, very concern right now in India, because under the absence of right now, the data protection law, because data protection law right now in the already draft is ready, but it's not now it passed in the parliament. So when it's going to be passed, then after we are going to protect our own data. And that's why this data protection law discussed about the data localization related issue. So these are some of the things that we need to be keep in mind. And there is some small button over there in each and every application that is considered as a privacy policy. Now, because the privacy policy is more than 10 pages or 15 pages and written in a very small letter, we are not supposed to read each and everything on this part privacy policy. But as a law person, I would like to say that privacy policy is basically a contract between you and that developer, application developer. And what happened that the contract said clearly that whatever data or whatever permission you are giving to the app developer, they are supposed to share those things with the third party. Now, they are not mentioning who are the third party, but they are mentioning third party, and third party can be anybody. And that is really a critical situation, because the recent time that in this condition, if we already observe that China is going to make a number of such applications which are exactly useful to us in our daily work. But these all applications are ultimately sharing our detail, and that's why there are a lot of things are going on. There are a lot of movements are going on to just uninstall the Chinese application. I'm come to this point, which are those applications. Before that, we need to be quickly go through with the different point also same time. Now, here the some of the modus operandi going on with the BEC attack. BEC attack is a business email compromising. And these are the Nigerian person who are actually committed all this thing. Recently, from the January 30 to April 30, there are almost 90 days, a lot of attacks are there. And particularly, they are making such kind of email on the name of WHO. And there are different kind of organization. And you are supposed to believe those particular the email are coming from the those organization, and ultimately what happened that when you are clicking those particular email, you are supposed to be click on that link, then you are going to be vulnerable on the internet. So these are considered the BEC attack which are happening now. See, I am just giving you one of the campaign name here. Maybe you see in my screen that coronavirus in Indonesia. Know how to protect and prevent yourself. Don't get infected. Now, this is a kind of tagline and subject is going to be made on the email, and they are trying to insist you to click on those links which are basically provided in the email. And that way, once you are clicking on that link, what happened that there are some kind of malicious software or there are some kind of malicious script is going to be installed in your phone or any your system, and they are going to be controlling all these things. So, and sometimes there are the phishing emails also. So these are the things that are going on with this kind of campaign. Here also mentioned that there are the recently attack on the DocuSign. Now DocuSign is one of the very important software which allows you to be just signed digitally on your document. Now the Microsoft is they are putting this kind of DocuSign related phishing email to you, and what they are doing, the attacker sent an email. And impersonation and automated email from DocuSign means that it's a DocuSign company. So you supposed to believe that the DocuSign company is sending you this email and copying the content used by the email from the company. And the email claims that there are the documents sent to the user and review from the CU or COV electronic documents. So these are some of the things they are doing with this kind of email. So who actually receive those emails, they are supposed to believe that this email is coming from the DocuSign and this is a genuine email. And once you are going to be open such email, you are supposed to going to be concerned. That's why I'm giving you certain tips on that also, that how can you check whether this is a phishing email or not. And that's why you need to be very, 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 very alert on those things. So another thing that maybe you know, understand that with the COVID-19, there are almost 6,000 plus fake domain name register. Fake domain name is a domain name register by the cyber criminals. And the fake domain name like that particular COVID-19.edu, COVID-19.com, or just know how to save with the COVID-19. And on the name of COVID, there are 6,000 plus domain names they are registered. And what they are doing with those all domain name, they are keep sending different kind of emails to you, to the different person. And that with this particular email, you are supposed to believe that there are certain sharing the tips on the safety, because we all are afraid with the COVID-19 right now. In this situation, they are taking the advantage of this situation. So they are playing with the mindset of the people, and that is the reason. And how they are playing with the mindset, because right now we are all are scared with this particular virus. And in this situation, they are particularly supposed to see some certain kind of remedy purpose or remedial things, or how to save your life, or this kind of tips with the mail. So we completely can access those email, or maybe we're going to be click on those email, and then suppose number of time we also share. So in this situation, ultimately that we are going to be make ourselves vulnerable on the internet. There are same kind of attack also happen with the WordPress, and WordPress is a very famous platform to make a website, right? So in 2020, there are a number of plugins also going on with the WordPress. If you want to make some kind of facility or features add to your website, you need to be go through with the plugins. So these plugins are different kind of things, that they are themes are available, and those themes are also going to be infected by the cyber criminals. There are very well known themes are www.downloaderfreethemes.com.co. Then the themesubmit.com, and there are so many. I already mentioned these names. So yeah. CodeSpree. So these are some of the fake. I am not saying the fake, but infected WordPress plugins, which are basically installed. And what happened after you are installing such plugins? When you are installing such plugins, then your website is going to be vulnerable. Not only vulnerable, but at the same time, your whatever the data you are storing with your database is also going to be explored by the cyber criminals. And that are the real concern right now. Now, in the COVID-19, there are a lot of people are aware with the, we are flooded with a lot of information. Now with the WhatsApp, with the different platform, with the newspapers, with the news on the TV news. And of course that on the different media, on the live TVs, on the internet, there are a lot of news are coming, and we are keep sharing all this news on the different platform. Now, this is a real concern then, that whenever we are sharing such news, whether those news are genuine or not, that you need to be understand. And how can you confirm that particular news are genuine or not, right? And recently there also one campaign is going to be run by the very well-known application called TikTok, Matkar Forward. So I already put the Matkar Forward means you are not supposed to forward the message whatever received from any sources. But at the same time, what can you do? You need to keep in mind that how can you understand, or how can you know that that what is a fake news, or who actually why? How can I particularly understand or make sure that whether this is genuine or not? So there are some of the things that you need to be keeping in your mind. Now I am sharing some of the very popular things that maybe it come across you. These are some of the things are coming to you on your WhatsApp platform or your email platform. That there are a lot of related with the government scheme. Now they are keep putting all this kind of news on the media, that government launched a beta version of Namaste video conferencing alternative of the Zoom, right? Recently that we are in the very priorly, they are saying that the Zoom is not a secure platform. But recently that after the lot of advancement and lot of the update, Zoom is making itself a very secure platform. And there are a lot of also rumors are going on that Zoom is basically a Chinese application, and that our servers are installed in the China, and our all information is going to be China. Yeah, of course that the developer is a Chinese, but it's situated in the US only, and their server is not in China, but they are situated all over even the German and different platform. So again, that it is the one kind of rumor that Zoom is not secure and all. If you are taken the enough precaution, you are making yourself secure. But not only the Zoom, but whatever application you are installing in your phone, how can you make sure that these are the secure application, right? So these are some of the myths are going on. There some of the myths I also want to discuss, that people in the number of people have a mind that, sir, I am making my system very secure. Now, how can you make the system secure? So somebody told that, sir, we are antivirus software in our system, so I am secure. Sir, I have a very good firewall, so I am secure. I have my office with the security, 27001 security audit, so I am secure. So these are the some of the things are the myth in the cyber world. I always used to say that there is nothing like an absolute security in the cyber world. So whenever somebody claims that I am providing absolute security on the internet, so it's a completely a myth, and it is not going to be justified. Now see, I'm already sharing that these are a number of things which are fake news are going on, and maybe you see over there that center likely to be reduced the retirement age to 50 in coronavirus crisis. Now it is again a fake news, and people are keep sharing all these things, and again that is a screen of the Bharatiya Dursanchar Vibhag sabhi mobile user ko 3 mahine tak ke liye internet dene ke liye elan nahi kiya. Now yani kiya hai wo pehle kaisa tha. So these are the things which are fake. Now I am also sharing some of another thing that again that which are related to the PM Prime Minister related some scheme offers, right? And again that you are supposed to say that the Prime Minister is going to be Kalyan Yojana and 500 rupees to your account, right? So these are the things that keep going on. People are victimized. People are keep sharing all this thing on the internet, and they are victimized as well as the other person also going to be victimized. So these are the fake news, and right now the fake news. No doubt government is developing their own channels, and there are other resources I also discussed in this platform. But this is our moral responsibility, first of all. I always used to say that as a responsible citizen of India, that we need to be keeping in mind that we always used to be go through with the source of the information. We need to be just double check with the source of the information, and we just tally those information with the any reliable person or any genuine news channel. And then after we are going to be share such news. You are not supposed to. Yes, yes, sir.
Sir, kindly admit some people because people are there. Kindly admit some participants.
Okay.
Admit all.
Yeah, I put it.
Okay, thank you.
So
and, 1 minute, sir. And
yes.
Some Mrs. Harmeet Kaur is there. Kindly mute your audio, otherwise you will be removed. Ms. Kaur, I am requesting you to mute your audio. Ms. Harmeet Kaur, please sir, you can continue.
Okay. So the next point is that what is social engineering? Now, this is a very popular word in the cyber world. It is called considered as a social engineering. Now, anyone know that what is a social engineering? Just put your comment yes or no on the chat box. You are understand about what is social engineering. Now, see, social engineering is a thing that people are basically calling you. It is we can call that is a wishing attack, and they are a caller, or maybe they are sometime they are doing some kind of sharing some on the different platform information. They try to develop a healthy relation with you and just keep you in the some of the subject. I have just give you the example that somebody call you that sir, I am calling from the Paytm. And that is your KYC is going to be expired soon. So we request you that please just follow this link and just click on that link, or maybe they are providing some number over there and just call us for that same thing. Now see, people are actually right now in this COVID situation. Really, I earlier said that they're afraid from the different kind of thing. And because of the digital medium is only right now available to for any kind of conversation or any communication. So they basically believe that, oh, if suppose this kind of thing happened, then how can I pay my bills or how can I do all these things? So they immediately keep in, they are trapped in that particular conversation. And that person is a very well trained person for this kind of crime, criminal activities. And what they are doing, they are just keeping you this kind of message come to your SMS, maybe in your phone. Or in your WhatsApp message, the dear Paytm customer, your Paytm. Now this here the mention not the full spelling of the Paytm. It's a PYTM. Your Paytm KYC has been suspended. Call Paytm office. Now they are providing the office number, right? This number is not basically from the office of the Paytm. whether that suspected person, that the particular cyber criminal is basically putting that number. And whenever you are calling on that number, they are saying that, okay, sir, please tell your details, your personal details, your financial details. And then after they say, okay, your detail is telling, now you need to be, first of all, install this application which we are calling, because we need to be see that whether it's completely working or not. So they are telling you that the such application names are maybe the AnyDesk or the Quick Support or the TeamViewer. So what this application are basically, their application is mirror your phone. They are mirror your phone, and whatever you are doing on your phone, they are basically, they are monitor your each and every activity. When you are putting your debit card number, because they are saying that you can just, whether your KYC is clear or not, you can just transfer a very nominal amount like 10 rupees to that particular account. So whenever you are putting your in a mobile wallet, in a Paytm wallet, 10 rupees, you are just transferring this amount from your debit card or your credit card, debit card from the your phone. And what is, you are putting your debit card as well as your PIN number, they are actually monitor each and everything. And that's why they are giving you, they are taking control of your phone, because they are mirror your phone. And they can easily doing a fraud with this kind of thing. So these are the modus operandi called the social engineering. And this is the very common. This is not only the Paytm, but sometimes you can get the message on the different insurance company name also. Sometimes you can get the name of the Bajaj Finance. And they are basically literally playing with your mind. They are saying that, sir, your loan is, certain loan is going on. And you are paying almost, your loan is closed, but you are paying two more installments. So we want to reimburse your those two installments. Kindly do whatever we are saying. So they are playing with the psychology of the people, and that is what I am saying, that because see what happened, that the our human nature is a greedy. Our nature is a greedy. So they are using this greediness as a tool. Now whenever I am offering certain free things, absolutely I am going for that, and there is no reason that particularly not Indian people, but all over the world, they can go for the free things, right? And suppose somebody give you some amount, of course the free, then of course we are going. Recently also one of the issue with the when the Reliance Jio and the Facebook is going to be tie up, then there is a one message is going on that Reliance Jio is going to be offer a 25 GB per day, and you need to be install update this application, and you need to be click on that link. So these kind of things are keep happening, and they are literally, and people are keep sharing all these things. So what is happening? Due to the lack of the knowledge, we are basically putting ourselves vulnerable on the internet. At the same time, other people also going to be vulnerable due to your this kind of activity. So you need to be keep in mind all these things. Of course, that recently for the fund transfer also, there are a lot of messages are going on with the PM fund transfer. The PM cares that there are SBI, this is the original UPI ID. But there are a number of fake IDs are going on, like PM care at YBL, PM cares at PNB, PM cares at the VS Bank, PM cares at the UPI, HDFC Bank, PM cares SBI. So these are the some of the, see the PM care at SBI is a very similar ID which the previous. But here you need to keep in mind that PM cares at SBI is the real your UPI ID. And if suppose you install the Arogya Setu application, they are also providing this option to be directly donate from that application only. And not only that, they are also offering you very good information on that particular application. Even though you can just go through with the website of the mygovernment.in also to tell you all these things. Now, this is also one of the recent crime are going on, because due to the COVID, a lot of people are not going to pay their installment. So there is a one message is going on the internet that that in such a fraud, the customer get that calls asking to share their OTP in order to postpone their loan EMIs. Now, to postpone the loan EMIs, you need to be share your OTP. OTP means the one-time password. Now, see, RBI number of times say, your bank number of times say that you need to be done. Bank is never going to be asked your OTP any on the telephone or on the messages, right? You are not supposed to share your OTP because it's a very confidential information. So you are not, it's a sensitive data. In our world, it's a sensitive data. So in the legal language. So you are not supposed to share your CVV number, your debit card number with anybody. But unfortunately, people are victimized because of lack of the awareness, and they are keep sharing because they want to delay their EMI. So they are basically sharing those with OTP, and they are going to be victimized with this kind of crime. So be aware about this kind of crime. At the same time, recently what happened that with the, because we all know that Arogya Setu application is a very, very important. and Arogya Setu application downloaded number of times was a million in a very small period. Now the one of the Pakistani group exactly create a similar kind of app called arogyasetu.apk. Now what is the difference between the original application and this particular Arogya Setu APK? Now Arogya Setu APK is basically starting, maybe you are seeing in the screen, on the screen, that this starting with the ARO GYA. In the original Arogya Setu application, there is a double ARO UGU, Arogya Setu. Now APK is basically they are sharing this application on the WhatsApp message, and whenever you are going to download the Arogya Setu, you need to be go to the Google Play Store and you need to be download from there. Now what thing you need to be keep in your mind, that okay, whether this application are genuine, because number of times there are a lot of fake application available on the Google Play also. So how can you come to know that whether this application is genuine or not, and whether we need to be use those application or install those application or not? So you need to be double check with the application, who is the developer of the application. Now in particular our Arogya Setu application, there is a government called the government NIC body, e-governments developed this application. They are mentioning the developer name, so it is a genuine application. You need to be come to know that. But the same time what happened, there are lot of other applications are available on the internet, and they are doing, because they are similar kind of names, and people are misled and misguided. So what can you do to save your site? So first tips is there for that. How can you check this application? You need to be check that how many times this particular application is downloaded. It's more than 50,000. Possibly it's the genuine app. Secondary, who is the developer? Now there are the two tag over there, that top developer tag and editor choice. So editor choice and top developers say that this is something, a genuine application, right? Then after, you need to be go through you can also ask to the Google that whether this application is secure or not. It is simply, you can ask to the Google whether this application is secure or not with the mic. So what Google do, I am not saying that the Google show you each and every time a particular very secure result, or maybe the always a true result. But if there is a lot of reviews are there, then he can come to know, and he can just collect the review and say that this application is not good. And number of times you can observe that there are a lot of reviews are written on the application. So just check and go through with the reviews, whether those applications, reviews are genuine or not, or whether this application is genuine or not. And then after you can install those applications. So these are the things that you need to be do. Hello, participants. I request the participants, please mute your mic. Otherwise, we need to be remove you from this meeting. Please mute your mic. Thank you. So these are some of the tips to understand that whether this application is genuine or not on the Google Play Store or on the Mac, right? Now, see, these are some of the things I need to be discussed that forwarding any kind of news or message to your WhatsApp group or friend. Now, maybe that you are going to be forwarding all these things on the Google Play on the WhatsApp or on the different media. On the Facebook, or sometimes on the through the mail also, sometimes the Snapchat, Instagram, there are a lot of platforms available. So whether there is a what are the remedy, what can you do, because there are a lot of things happen. So recently Maharashtra government also issued one of the notification for the Google WhatsApp admin, and these are the things they are mentioning, that it is very clear that what an administrator should do. So ensure each and every group member is reliable. Now it is very important each and every person reliable. Member should be informed about the rules and posting in the group. Now every WhatsApp group need to be mentioned, first of all, rules, what to post and what not, right? If anyone can post nonsense thing or some kind of content, that immediately that any person is come to know that, they need to be removed from the group, right? Because the disturbing content, because there are a lot of contents are going on. So if the disturbing content are making, and what is the purpose of the group? So if you are posting something against the purpose of the group, again that it is you need to be remove the person. So these are the things they are mentioning. Alter and the prevent members from the sharing objectionable content. Alter and prevent from the, now you are not supposed to share objectionable content. Objectionable content is come across under the definition of the certain pornographic content or some kind of religious related content or some political views like that. So you are not supposed to, whatever your view, you suppose the group is made for the any discussion, particularly if I am taking the example of this webinar. So if the group is making for the webinar, you need to be only discuss with the webinar ladies. You not you have to share a different kind of things on the group. Inform the policy member, report the mischief if something is posting certain thing that good admin, there's a responsibility to admin that you need to be immediately informed to the police. And regularly monitor the content bearing share to the group. Now you, as an admin, this is your responsibility that who actually sharing. So admin job is quite difficult. And that's why if we are sharing and we are keep making a different kind of group right now. In COVID-19, I also observed that people are making lots of group. And sometimes they forget that they are in the group. And if somebody is posted nonsense thing in the group, then what happened that number of time, if you are a good, group admin. So in that case, you are also liable for certain things and that you need to be very conscious about that. See, there is a 2018, there is a very good judgment come in the Madras High Court. Now, what this judgment is say, you need to be very conscious about this judgment because now what in the past years and also in the recent time also, I observe that people are keep sharing the different kind of information on the internet because knowing about that what is the harm or it's correct or not. But this judgment says that forward message is equal to accepting the message and endorsing the message. Now, if you are forwarding certain message, it is equivalent to endorsing that this message is true as far as my knowledge. That's why I'm forwarding. And that is the equivalent punishment going to be happen with this kind of thing. See, the section is applicable to the originator who exactly create this message of this false message and applicable to the person further forward or share this message. So this is the liability of the person who share the message without knowing the truth. Number of times, not only the COVID, but in the situation of the any person can share the religion related or caste related messages or particularly any kind of. These kind of messages are not supposed to be shared because if you are sharing such messages, it is considered as a equivalent and you are equally liable for that punishment. Now, what are the punishment under section 505 of the IPC? The punishment is particularly to be spreading circular rumor statement. Now, recently there are a lot of rumors are going on about the workers, about the laborer who are basically migrate or they are going to be going outside of the state. So there are a lot of rumor going on the WhatsApp and different media, and people are gathering in the against the railway station in the Mumbai. We already observe that, right? So this kind of thing are happened due to these fake rumors and. These are equivalently liable with the under section 505 of the IPC, and up to the 3 years, this is imprisonment and with the fine, this is the punishment. And particularly with the National Disaster Management Act under section 54, if you are circulating certain messages related, which are basically panic, creating a panic in the society, right? So again, that it is going to be a punishable and it is up to the one year punishment, imprisonment as well as the fine. So how can you know that these messages are genuine or not? So number of time people asking me, sir, hume kaise pata chalega ye message hai ki nahi, humne to ek good faith mein isko share kar diya, right? Maine to apni good faith mein kiya. Now this is what people are saying, but see, what you need to be understand, there are a lot of things are available. You need to be keep tally all this all our available messages. So there are some side website I can just give you. There is a first is a Snoop. There is a one of the very good website that you can go through with the any kind of you can tally any news from that. There's a PolitiFact is a political news. If any political news, you can just go through the PolitiFact news, particular this website. Then factcheck.org is again a very, very important website to be just go through with the check the news is genuine or not. Then again, the Probulica is one of the website that you can go through. Alt News is a very important, is all over the world and India is also there. Alt News is one of the very good website to be tally any kind of fake news. Then Boom Fact Check, then SM Hoaxslayer. These are some of the website that you can go through with the website and you can check the news is genuine or not. Again, that if you are not supposed to go through with the website, if government related any kind of information, you can go through the PIB Fact Check. This is a Facebook page available on the Facebook. And this is a government page, and you can just tally any kind of news from the PIB Fact Check also. There is also one WhatsApp number mentioned over there, that is the 87997-11259. On that WhatsApp number also, you can share the news and they will answer you that whether the news is genuine or not. And then after you can share those news. Again, and you can email also with the PIBFactChecker@gmail.com. So these are the things again that if sometimes what happened, not only the content, but sometimes pictures, videos also going to be morphed, and sometimes they are creating a different kind of videos with the new technology called this deepfake web. So deepfake web is one of the technology. With that particular, you can just change the faces of the people. You can just alter those faces. You can just sophisticatedly you can do all the alteration in the images, right? So how can this particular images is genuine or not, or video is genuine or not? So there are also some of the tools available on the internet that you can check with this tool. So I mentioned over here, one tool is reverse image search from Google. So if you are putting any pictures, is image is genuine or not, that is who actually published. Because previously also a lot of political related leaders images are posting on the images, whether it's genuine or not, or particular that area is genuine or not. So with the reverse image tool, you can check all these things. Then again, the pre-post search by image, this is also one of the tools. You can check the image is genuine or not. So these are some of the tools that with that you can understand that image is genuine or not. Now, how many agree with this particular picture right now? How many are agree with this? Just raise your hand, or just give your comment yes or no. So in the COVID situation, what happened that people are busy with their own gadgets, right? Recently in the center, we see the little boy is also working in the platform, in the phone. His daddy is watching some TV and the mother is doing on the different devices, right? So this is a situation, current situation is right now in each and every home. Maybe you are agree with me. I am supposed to say that is you are agree with the, this is the situation right now in each and every home. Now you are not supposed to say no to the devices, say no to the children. But what happening that due to all these things, there are some serious kind of cases are come across to us. Because one of the case I would like to discuss that we had one case, and one mother said us, sir, my son is basically saying something to us, and I said, what is he saying? So he said, she told us, sir, she told that my son told me that whatever I am seeing is I see each and every person naked. Now it is a very serious concern. That is just a 6 or 7 years guy, child, and he said like that. Now how it possible that, because it is really a very very serious concern. That particular child said two or three times to her mother, but after 3 or 4 times that mother is going to be serious, and he contacted us. And we just take the phone and phone of her mother, and we say that how many applications right now you are installing in your phone. So she said, sir, I am just using 3 or 4 applications, whatever the actually I am using. But the same time, what we observe in her phone, that there are a lot of game applications are also installed. There are a lot of free game application also installed. Now I always used to say that there is nothing like a free on the particular in real world, and on internet there is nothing like a free lunch. So whenever you are installing such free application or free game application, what happened that certain scripts are going on install in your phone maybe sometimes. And there are some of the pop-up screen are going on. The pop-up screen are basically from this some pornographic website. And what happened with that child, that whenever he click on that website, whenever he click on the game, they pop up this kind of naked images and particular videos. And he come across such pornographic content, and he showed out, see, what happened to this small mind? They are basically they disturbed there, because number of times he came across such content, and that is a really very serious part of the internet world. And that's why we need to be secure our next generation, and we need to be monitor that what actually going on the system. Because not only that child, but whenever you are giving your phone to your child, then of course that if some malicious script is going to be downloaded with such content, that of course you are also vulnerable to the cyber world. And there are lot of cases we have of the particular women harassment and the child particular child related issue. Of course the frauds are there, but these are the things which are going on. Now I am always used to say that how many you are saying sharing your secret with anybody? Yes or no, you are sharing your secret with anybody? Yes or no? So whenever I'm asking this question whenever I'm taking the session, number of people say, "Nice, sir, we are never share our secret." And of course that people are not sharing their secret, because the Chanakya statement is there that if you are sharing your secret with anybody, it destroy you, right? So I don't know if people have that mind in their mind or not, the statement of the Acharya Chanakya. But the same thing, right now what happening, that people openly saying, sir, we are not sharing our secret with anybody. But what happened that whenever you are downloading certain application in your phone and the use application, because we are not never go through with the privacy policy, they are taking, they are reading your each and every content, whatever you are storing in your SD card, whatever you are storing in your phone. So whatever information you are private is going to be a public. And WhatsApp policy also, they are putting over there in the agreement, in the WhatsApp, this all information, whatever you are sharing is a public information. You can just go through with the WhatsApp contract. They are clearly mentioned that all information you are sharing, this is a public information. So anyone can easily, of course, there's an end-to-end encryption. But whenever law enforcement asking for this such information, they need to be provided. And who knows that end-to-end encryption is secure or not? Because at the end of the day, the server is secured in the California. Whether this how people are basically tracking those data and they are again that use again us, we never know that. So again, I always do that. Just restrict it with the limited application in your phone. Don't install so many applications in your devices. Whatever application is basically important to you, just only put information. Install application only install those application only. So these are the some of the things which I need to be keep in your mind. Now what application said that jo tera hai wo mera hai, yani jo aapne share kiya hai wo sabhi kuch aapka jo hai wo bhi application ka hai, yani ki application developer ka hai, aur wo application developer usko kisi bhi tarah use kar sakta hai. Now that is what exactly you need to be keep in your mind. Now see here, there is a some of the thing I need to be mentioned that how this technologies work, right? I number of time asked that who own the internet, who own the internet, who actually owning the internet, or who governing the internet. So if I discuss this thing in context of this particular thing, before 10 years back, we can see that the all right now whatever we are using, of course, that the Google, of Alphabet Inc, the Microsoft right now, that is a Microsoft company, or Mac or Windows or Facebook or Instagram or WhatsApp or IBM or HP, right, or Dell. These all are companies from the Amazon, of course, right? All these platforms are probably belonging to USA. So ultimately, all these things are going to be governed by the USA. And the same time, in last 5 years, what happened that the all hardware part is going to be manufactured by the China. Now you can go through the each and every 80%, 90% phones, our smartphones are manufactured in China. Now all this Lenovo, all this Oppo, all this Vivo, and there are a lot of other Huawei is there. There are the biggest, Alibaba is there, JD.com is there. So these all are the giant company of the China, and they are basically manufacturing the all hardware part. Now software part owning by the USA, hardware part is owning by the China, and they are all, not only the China, because the hardware part is cover your router, your switches, your modems, your tablets, each and everything is coming on in that, right? So yes, sir.
Admit people, sir. They are waiting.
Okay. Admit, sir. So, I am audible, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. So again, that the China is owning that hardware part, and they are what they are doing. They are keep installing different kind of embedded script in their hardware, and they are keep collecting all this information, whatever information right now we are sharing. And this is also the real concern to the new India. And because of that, we have right now a 70% user right now. We are the second highest user of the phone, smartphone, as well as the social media platform. It is a really concern, because I earlier said that we are not using technology, but technology is using us. And that's why, if you are Amazon, if you are log into the Amazon with the Facebook login, what they are doing, they are sharing each and every information regarding on the different platform. So that's where these all these things are working on the internet, and that's why it's a real concern, right? Now the internet is basically, you need to be understand the anatomy of the World Wide Web, right? Now World Wide Web is basically divided in the three major part: its surface, deep, and dark. Now, whatever right now we are using, Wikipedia, Google, Bing, Facebook, whatever platform we are using, it's considered as a surface web. It's considered as only 4% of total internet. But at the same time, there is a 90%, it's called the deep web, where all these servers are located. Each and every servers are located in the dark web. Now, when I'm telling the dark web, the deep web, it is basically a financial record, multinational companies record, government resources, then the different computer websites, then legal documents, medical hospitals record, all the even Facebook server, Google server. Major data breaches are going to be happen with this deep web only, with the different banks records are there. You are not supposed to go without the permission or with the authentication. You can operate all these things. In surface web, it is the index data. Anyone can operate that. Index data means like that in your book, there is an indexing in which page there is a one, what, which chapter is coming on, right? On what, then you can immediately go through with the index and you can find that chapter. The same time is on the surface web, is the index data is available for all and it is going to be searched. But in the deep web, no one can enter. That is a particular, you need a specific permission to enter in this particular area. So deep web is a very, very important part where major data is going to be, big servers are there. And again, the dark web is a 6%. Now, I'm not saying that dark web is basically a place where all the intellectual people are sitting over there. So they are not criminal, but they are basically, they have a special knowledge about the technology. They are the hardcore technocrat people. And what they are doing a lot of things over there. They are drug trafficking are there. There is a human trafficking are there. You can hire any person, any killer who from that particular dark web. There are a lot of debit card and credit card PIN numbers. Cards are basically on the cell. Recently, the Truecaller data is going to be a sell on the dark web. Truecaller application, maybe you know that. So the almost 2.5 crores data is going to be sell on the dark web. Recently, one of the Unacademy is one of the biggest platform of the education in the Bangalore universe. So it's also hacked within last month only. So their user database, now user database is considered as is a user ID and password. It's going to be a sell, the email ID and all these things. So all these things are happen on the dark web, and dark web major business is going with the pornography, the child pornography. And again, that the dark web currency, maybe we already know the name is Bitcoin. So it's all governing with the virtual currency. Now in the future is also of the virtual currency all over the world. But again, that Bitcoin, there are a number of such virtual currency, but Bitcoin is a very popular currency. So they are using all this thing on the dark web. And all this kind of platform are basically used for the criminal activities, dark web particularly. There are a lot of research are also there, but of course that criminals are highly intellectual people. I cannot use, sorry, the word of the criminals, but they're highly intellectual people. So they are sitting there. Now, I putting one of the question again that if you are somebody without asking them, if you operate some computer or device without asking them, or change the data on the someone else computer without permission, what happens then? If you just take any device of any person, it is also against without the permission and consent that it is considered as a crime, is a cyber crime particularly. And if you alter or tamper the data, maybe you all aware about the one of the scene of the Three Idiots movie. In that particular movie, when the Amir Khan is just change the script of the Chatur, right? And there is a word, maybe you very famous word is putting over there, right? The whole incident is very, very hilarious. But these are the, in they are showing in a very hilarious way. And of course, that is a funny manner. But again, that if you are tampered the data, if you are tampering certain things, or if you are operating certain thing without the knowledge of the person, then again, that it is considered as a crime up to 3 years imprisonment, and is a crime under Section 43I of the Information Technology Act. So again, that you need to be keeping in your mind all these things. So be careful, because it's a crime. Now, smartphone, right now, you say that smartphone is not a smartphone. Basically, we are not, our phone is smarter than us. So we need to be alert whenever you are using this such kind of smartphone on the internet, right? Now, some of the types of cybercrime already discussed, that social media fake profile, because we are sharing a lot of information on social media. So criminal easily access all your information and they can verify. I said that you are not supposed to share your personal information. Whenever you are sharing your personal information, you are inviting the stranger people and to just in your life, and they are going to be interfere in your life. So you are not supposed to share each and every personal information, particularly. Most probably, we are observing that the women are going to be victimized with this kind of fake crime. Cyber stalking is there. That is one of the very serious crime. Then again, that extortion now is a sextortion, considered as a sextortion. So people are blackmailing with the different kind of clips. They are modify the script as videos and sometimes morph the pictures, and they are going to be asking money. We have a number of such cases. I'm not right now because we have a limited time, so I'm not supposed to discuss each and every point right now. But these are some of the things which are happened on the internet. What are the roots of the cybercrime? I already discussed that the lack of knowledge about the best cybersecurity practices. I discussed a number of things, ignorance about the privacy policy, share the personal details and social networking site. Again, that we are keep sharing all these things, share personal detail, exhibition. Hum kahin pe bhi exhibition mein jaate hai, tabhi apna number hi leke aate. Now your number is basically associated with your bank account. You are not supposed to put everywhere your number, because whenever you are putting your number and email ID, again that you are supposed to be vulnerable, and anyone can use all this information without your knowledge. Over trusting. We are very over trusting. Hum kisi ko bhi apna phone dete, yaar phone kar le chalo. 2 minute के लिए कि आप किसी को फोन देते हैं तो दे कैन इंस्टॉल एनी काइंड ऑफ एप्लीकेशन इन योर फोन एंड मे बी पॉसिबल दैट एप्लीकेशन इज गोइंग टू बी कंट्रोल योर फोन. सो यू आर नॉट सपोज, यू आर वेरी विजिलेंट व्हेन यू आर पासिंग योर फोन टू एनी बडी, पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रेंजर पीपल, राइट. देन अगेन वी आर वेरी पुअर पासवर्ड प्रैक्टिसेस. नाउ व्हाट आर द पासवर्ड वी आर पुटिंग? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 ए बी सी डी ई एफ जी पासवर्ड 1 2 3. माई नेम चिंतन, मीन्स चिंतन पाठक 1 2 3. Then your mobile number, then your family member number, maybe your son number, maybe your birth date number. So these are the very common password that we are using, and these password are easily guessable. Not only the guessable, easily crackable. So there are a number of softwares available in the market. They are allowing the people. They are basically, these are called a dictionary words. The dictionary words are easily crackable. So you need to be make a password in a combination of upper, lower case, and the special character, and the alpha and numerical. And more than 8 to 10 characters. And of course that you can make a password, because it's a long process. I'm not supposed to discuss this right now thing, but you can make the password according to that. And you can make yourself secure. Again, that ignorance of the mobile purchasing and repairing. Now, a number of times we observe that, because we have a number of such cases when people are giving their phone for the repairing, they are not formatted the data. They are not remove the their SD card. And what happened that SD card data, whatever the information stored on the SD card, they are using that information against that person, or maybe they are selling from that repairing shop. And sometimes we have a number of such cases when the women are victimized, or some teenagers, girls are victimized, because they are studying in the different state and living in hostel, and they have some kind of data and photos over there, and if they are giving that, so they are victimized on the day. So we have a such number of such type of cases. So we be careful whenever you are giving your phone to the, just remove your SD card, just format your phone, and then after you can pass on to the. Now this is the legal infrastructure available on the internet that is going to be protect you on the internet. That Indecent Representation of Women Act, one of the act, sexual harassment at workplace, if you are passing the colorful remark to the any women when in the workplace. Right, so it is against the crime protection of the child. POCSO is the number of child pornography related issue. Online child pornography, we are circulating any video, certain things by mistake, also it is again a crime. Then Indian Penal Code is a very basic law, the Immoral Traffic Prevention Act, and again the Information Technology 2000. This is a legal infrastructure right now available for the internet, and of course the CRPC, Criminal Procedure Code, is basically going to be work on that area. So what is important for you? Of course, the netizen, the cyber world, the cyber security. But at the same time, what else? The online reputation also very important, because whatever you are doing, they are making your digital footprint. Now, digital footprint is basically a thing which is exactly going to be identify you that how you are working online, because people are very nice online, but of course they are not in the offline message or particularly in offline thing. So again, that your online identity is very important. Individuality makes you a unique. It is the build the online reputation. So in which forum you are working, means if you are, I am right now with the lawyer forum, with the any good cyber law forum, with the academic forum. So in which group you are working, it is very important. If I am on the Facebook, it's okay. But if I am in the LinkedIn, so LinkedIn again is the professional background. Somebody endorses your skill. So again, it's a good thing. So again, that in from what background you are there, it is very important on the in the cyber world, and it's create. Agar if I am sharing number of selfie on this on the social media, any person can just try to be judge you that this person is selfish, maybe is a self-centered person. If we are going to be recruit such person, they are going to be, they're not used for the organization, because your nature is going to show with they are predict your nature with your posting also sometimes, right? So in future also, what happened that people are going to be recruit you from your whatever you are sharing on the internet on different platform, and in from which background you are belonging. So you can make your own website, you can write a good blog, so it create a positive digital footprint from you. Now these are the some of the application I need to be just specify, because in 2017 our government banned 42 Chinese application. Now these application are basically banned because of their they are installing in the particularly our army armed force, and they come to know they are sharing certain deep data. Recently, maybe yesterday only, one of the very good platform government banned is a WeTransfer. Now the WeTransfer is one of the background that you can share the big 2 GB up to 2 GB file with this particular background particular application, but government yesterday banned this WeChat WeTransfer platform also. So these are the application majorly. These application are Chinese application, WeChat, ShareIt, Truecaller. Again, Truecaller. I recently said that there's the data biggest data breach ever. Truecaller recently happened. UC News, UC Browser. Then again that Mi Store, 360 Security, Clean Master. So these are the Chinese. There are 42 Chinese applications. This we need to be very conscious about that. That whether this is actually useful to us or not. If not, then we need to be think on that whether we need to keep in, because whenever they are updating, they are sharing your data. Now China has each and everything, each every option. They have their own Google. It is not the Google. They are not using Google, but they have a Baidu. They are not using the Google Map. They are using the Baidu Maps and Google Maps. These are the two applications. They are not using WhatsApp, but they have their own application WeChat. They are alternative of YouTube. You can say that there is a Todu Youku. This is one of the option of the YouTube. They are using Spotify. This is a music application. Basically, we are using in India Spotify. So there have a QQ Music. Again, that the very famous application for the Chinese application Tinder. It is basically a dating application. They have their own application called Tantan. Now the alternative of Instagram. Again they have their own application. And again, the TikTok is very, very famous platform right now. So again, that is a Chinese platform. So these are the some of the things that we need to be keep in mind, whether this application is useful, because they are developing there. And I earlier said that how they are monitoring your data with this application, right? And they are controlling your thoughts. They are controlling each and everything with this application. So we need to be as a new India, what we need to be keep in our mind that we need to be just try to be understand that. How this application, why I discuss all this cyber world working, because of you keep you understand that the technology is actually working in this manner, and they are taking our database and they are controlling our thoughts also. So that is a very, very important. They are controlling our thoughts, they are controlling our behavior, they are also controlling what to do and what to not do, right? So ultimately they are capturing our mindset, right? And that is a real concern for New India, and we need to be keep all this point in mind, and we need to be put our things. Now see, there is a recent application come in this Chinese app remover. There is 1 million plus downloaded right now. Now our one of the startup, I don't know particular the name, but in our Indian startup basically made this application, and this application claimed that if any Chinese application installed in your phone, that with this application they are going to be removed, and they are identify this application, and then after they remove this application, right? So, sorry. So whether particularly I already discussed the 42 application, whether this application in your phone you can download, but I had a serious concern about that, whether this application genuine or not, right? But in this particular moment, because see, people are keep downloading all this thing, and acha Chinese application hai, Chinese application ko humko nikal dena hai, theek hai, to ye main download kar deta hu, hum identify kar denge. Aur lekin ultimately ye bhi ek application hai, aur ye application bhi maybe possible hai ki aapka data share kar sakti hai. So we need to be keep in mind, और कई बार हमको परमिशन नहीं मांगी है फिर भी वो बाईपास करके भी वो ले सकती है, that we need to be keep in mind. So again that this is all this technological world. China has their own chakravyuh, because they have their hardware part, they have a software part, and of course they are acquiring lot of thing right now, whatever going on, we already aware about all this thing. So we need to be set our mind in that manner के what can we do next for this kind of in this situation. So again, that we are all in the right now quarantine. From the today also, we are on the working. But nowadays, because we are staying in the home, we need to be keep our Wi-Fi also secure, and very importantly, there are a lot of things, because if you are not securing your Wi-Fi, again that you are putting yourself in a danger. So there are the some of the thing I need to be share with you very quickly because we are running in a short of time right now, maybe sir, right? So I am just going with the very few things. I am just seeing you one of the website only. You can just go through with the website. It is called metageek.com website. You can just download Insider. This is one of the tools. It is a free tool. And it shows you that whether your home Wi-Fi is secure or not, right? So this is, you can download and you can just go through with this. And after that, you can remove. और मैंने जो बताया वो चाइनीज एप्लीकेशन भी अगर डाउनलोड करना है तो आप कर सकते हो उसको जो भी चाइनीज एप्लीकेशन आपको डिटेक्ट होते हैं उसको रिमूव करिए उसके बाद वो एप्लीकेशन को भी रिमूव कर दीजिए तो यू कैन डू दैट राइट सो बट यू आर नॉट सपोज टू पुट दिस एप्लीकेशन ऑल द टाइम इन योर फोन राइट देन अगेन दैट देर आर लॉट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी स्टैंडर्ड अवेलेबल ऑन द वाईफाई सो दिस आर द सम ऑफ द स्टैंडर्ड प्रीवियसली गोइंग ऑन वेब देन WPA एंड राइट नाउ WPA2 सो WPA2 इज वन ऑफ द रिसेंट स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ द इंक्रिप्शन And whenever your Wi-Fi security is concerned, you need to be put your very strong password and you need to keep change because people are just putting the very simple password with the Wi-Fi security at their router also. And they are never going to be changed. Number of times also, they are not going to be changed those passwords. So what can you do that? You can just put the very, I already discussed the password. How can you make the password? And there is an AES, this is Advanced Encryption Standard. There is a latest security features. So WPA plus AES, this is secure. Standard to secure your Wi-Fi, so you can put all this standard to in your Wi-Fi situation. So again, that here I am completing my session. I already go through with the each and every aspect of the security and how can we together make our India, our new India, a secure India. I always used to say that don't be a victim, be a responsible digital citizen. You are supposed to be, and there is nothing like an absolute security in the cyber world. So the first defense in the cyber world is your awareness. We are working keep far from the last almost 10 years on that area. I am keep awareing with the police department. We are working with our doctors, lawyers, and I'm taking the seminar all over the different kind of associations about the cyber security, particularly our corporates also, then our child and the colleges and schools also. But what we observe that people are ignoring the security part, and that is a real concern. You are not supposed to ignore the security part. I earlier said that cyber security is not a choice, it is a habit. You made to be habit about the security, and it's a regular practicing. Here I put one of the link also. You can just take this link from the link. Maybe I share with the Jaswant sir afterwards, and he can just circulate the link. So we are putting whatever we discuss, there are the 10 questionnaire I putting over there, and you can just go through with each and every question. And whether you are a responsible digital citizen or not, then you can judge after those questions. So here I conclude my session, and the floor is open for the question answer. So again, sir, I am going to be make you with the So Jaswant sir, I am making you right now host.
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, now you are a host, and now floor is open for any question answer, please.
Kindly, sir, stop screening sharing. Okay. Share screen stop. Yeah. It was quite enlightening moment. It was quite, you can say, educating lecture. How to use some apps very safe and in a very safe manner, and how to protect yourself from all these cyber crimes, right? It's very enlightening as well as a very educative lecture, sir. Sir, I have one question, one doubt. You have talked about the review, right? But if reviews are also possible, you have dummy reviews, right? For example, you have dummy reviews of that product, that app, right? So you can create many things because in the world of internet, everything is possible.
Yeah, see, is that's why I already say that there are a lot of reviews are there, and that's why you need to be try to be focused on what are the maximum reviews are there, what they are maximumly people are saying that, right? That is the one thing you can keep in your mind. And I also suggested that there are the two things are mentioned as editor choice and the top developer, right? So there are the some of the application which are good in a nature, and they are putting all these things, so they are considered as a editor choice or good application, right? So you can go through with those tag also, not only the with review, but you can go through with those things also. And yes, of course you are right that there are a lot of fake reviews are there, but you need to be go through the maximum reviews are what exactly there, right? And of course that I already said that you can just simply put that just open your Google and on the mic you can ask that, oh, whether this application or secure or maybe or not, then Google also give you a couple of good result for that. So you can go through with this to judge, right?
Is there any question from the participants?
Yes sir, I want to ask one question.
Please.
Sir, am I audible, sir?
Yes.
सर मैं डॉक्टर स्मित कुमार बोल रहा हूँ पंजाब से. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल सर. सर मेरा क्वेश्चन ये था, सपोज करो कि हमारा मोबाइल की इन्फॉर्मेशन हैक हो जाती है, हमारा क्रेडिट कार्ड नंबर भी चला गया, हमारा सीवीसी नंबर वगैरह भी चला गया. अगर मान लो सर किसी के पास चला भी जाता है, तभी अगर वो शॉपिंग मतलब कि उसको यूज करते हैं, तो उसका जो ओटीपी है वो तुम्हारे पर्सनल मोबाइल पे आएगा ना, वो तो कहीं और जाएगा नहीं, तो फिर वो कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं सर? मतलब ओटीपी तो जो है वो मेरे पर्सनल मेरे पास ही रहेगा ना, उसके बिना तो वो क्रेडिट कार्ड यूज ही नहीं हो सकता या डेबिट कार्ड सर.
या एब्सोल्युटली सर, रियली वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. व्हाट हैपन दैट समटाइम्स उसमें ऐसा होता है, कई बार आपके अंदर इसमें एक सॉफ्टवेयर आता है, कई बार जो लिंक होते हैं उसमें की लॉगर करके एक सॉफ्टवेयर आता है. तो की लॉगर क्या करता है, आपके स्क्रीन को रिकॉर्ड करता है पूरी तरह से, और वो आपका जो भी स्क्रीन आपका रिकॉर्ड करके वो जिसने वो भेजा वो स्क्रिप्ट वहां पे पहुंच जाता है. पहली बात ये, दिस इज अबाउट रिकॉर्डिंग, हाउ टू रिकॉर्ड योर स्क्रीन. Secondly, okay, I already earlier said that there are a lot of applications are going on, and those applications are basically considered as a AnyDesk or maybe the quick support. So they mirror your phone. So what, of course, you, आपका OTP अगर आपके पास आता है, लेकिन आपके अगर स्क्रीन को उसने मॉनिटर यानी मिरर किया हुआ है, तो वो वहां पे भी आपके फोन को इजिली देख सकते हैं, उसको पढ़ सकते हैं. तो दैट वे दे कैन कम टू नो दैट व्हाट इज योर ओटीपी.
सो दीज आर यस सर. सर वो तो पता चल गया सर. फिर इसका तो यही इलाज हुआ ना कि हम जो नंबर हमने क्रेडिट कार्ड के लिए दिया हुआ है वो हमले स्मार्टफोन का नंबर ना दें, सिंपल मोबाइल रखने उसका नंबर दें.
फिर वो एग्जैक्टली यानी इसीलिए मैं कई बार कहता हूँ, पहली फर्स्ट द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिस इज देयर यू कैन यूज मिनिमम एप्लीकेशन फर्स्ट थिंग. एक प्लेटफॉर्म को यूज करें पहली बात है. सेकंडली यू कैन डू दैट that I also use that if you it is going to be allow you can use the separate phone with the any kind of any communication with the bank. So wo platform ke liye you are not supposed to install your whole social media and everything in a one platform, because what happened that number of time why people are victimized, because due to the they are come across such links and some contents which they are with knowingly and unknowingly they can click on that, and they are going to be victimized because their data is going to be shared. So it is good option that you can use a separate phone or a very small standard phone
and separate mobile number, sir.
Of course that, and you can link up that number with that. You are not supposed to link this particular what is the open number, public number with that
with anyone, sir. With any app, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, मैं बोलना चाहता हूँ, sir.
Yes, please, sir.
जी नमस्कार sir. मैं डॉक्टर एके श्रीवास्तव बिलासपुर छत्तीसगढ़ से. सचमुच रियली सर बहुत अच्छा लगा, चूंकि साइबर के बारे में बहुत सारे कन्फ्यूजन थे और हम लोग चूंकि उतना नहीं जानते थे तो बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला. लेकिन एक थोड़ा पूछना है कि हम लोग जूम ऐप से जो अभी हम लोग पढ़ा रहे हैं, चाहे अभी आपने 10 मिनट पहले लेक्चर के पहले बताया कि कौन सा ऐप जो है ज्यादा सुटेबल है, सेफ है, उसको मैं नोट नहीं कर सका, स्क्रीन मैंने उससे याद नहीं कर सका, उसको बता दें. और क्या जूम में हम लोग जो पढ़ा रहे हैं, आजकल जूम है, कुछ लोग बोलते हैं गूगल मीट, कई तरह के लोग बताते हैं ऐसा कीजिए वैसा कीजिए, तो हम लोग इस मामले में चूंकि ये जानकारी नहीं है तो ये कंफ्यूज है. लेकिन फिर भी अब हम लोग पढ़ रहे हैं, चलो जो होगा देखा जाएगा. तो आपके नजर में अगर जूम ऐप के बारे में बताएं, अगर हम कर रहे हैं तो क्या सेफ्टी लें
जी,
या और कौन सा ऐप है जिसे हम पढ़ाए, जो दूसरी बात की दूसरे हमारे जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनके लिए भी इजी हो.
जी, रियली रियली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. ये क्वेश्चन मुझे कहीं बार पूछा गया है आगे भी हमारे अलग अलग सेशन में, तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सर, मैं आपसे ये कहना चाहूंगा इसके लिए कि मैंने बहुत लोगों को ये सजेस्ट किया है कि जूम के अंदर आप जो भी अपना ईमेल आईडी यूज करते हैं, वो ईमेल आईडी यानी कोई भी अगर ये वेबिनार के लिए पर्टिकुलर आप प्लेटफॉर्म में यूज कर रहे हैं, तो यू कैन यूज नॉट योर रेगुलर ईमेल आईडी, यू कैन क्रिएट अ डिफरेंट ईमेल आईडी फॉर ऑल दिस पर्पस, वेबिनार और आपको जो भी करना है। इसका रीजन मैं बता रहा हूँ क्यों करना है आपको, क्योंकि आप जूम का जो है, जूम आपको ये पूछता है कि भाई वी आर सपोज टू एक्सेस योर, वो कई बार कैलेंडर को मॉडिफाई करता है, कई बार वो आपको बोलता है कि भाई आपको इवेंट क्रिएट करना है तो हम कर देंगे। तो अल्टीमेटली क्या होता है कि आपके जो ईमेल आईडी के साथ जो भी कॉन्टेक्ट होते हैं वो भी शायद उसके अंदर शेयर हो जाते हैं, ठीक है। तो आपके रेगुलर ईमेल आईडी जो आपका है उसमें आपके कई सारे कॉन्टेक्ट है, आपके इवन आपका वो ईमेल आईडी आपका बैंक के साथ भी एसोसिएट हो सकता है, ठीक है। तो आपको आपको क्या करना है कि आपको ये सारे प्लेटफॉर्म के लिए यू नीड टू बी इंस्ट्रक्ट टू द स्टूडेंट ऑल्सो एज वेल एज फॉर यू एनी एकेडमिशियन, यू कैन डू दैट, कि आपका एक ईमेल आईडी अलग से होना चाहिए सारे प्लेटफॉर्म पे काम करने के लिए, जो आपके बैंक अकाउंट के साथ एसोसिएट नो नो के ना के आपके रेगुलर कोई भी कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट के अंदर उसका एक्सेस होता है, ठीक है। तो दैट इज द वन थिंग यू कैन डू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल। सेकेंडरी सर, आपने जो बोला कि सेफ ऐप कौन से है, तो मैं बताना चाहता हूँ आपको कि देर आर लॉट ऑफ प्लेटफॉर्म, गूगल मीट इज ऑल्सो वेरी गुड प्लेटफॉर्म, और ऐसे तो देखिए तो अभी जो लेटेस्ट जूम के अंदर जो अभी एंड टू एंड इंक्रिप्शन भी आया है, जो बोल रहे हैं वो कि अभी जो नया वर्जन जो है 5 में वो एंड टू एंड इंक्रिप्शन है, तो देर आर नथिंग वरीड अबाउट इट, और बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी आर वर्किंग विद अ लॉट ऑफ साइबर सिक्योरिटी एक्सपर्ट ऑल ओवर द इंडिया एज वेल एज द वर्ल्ड। तो उन लोगों का भी ये कहना है कि ठीक है एप्लीकेशन कोई भी आप डालो वो वल्नरेबल ही है, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि जूम वल्नरेबल है, कोई भी एप्लीकेशन वल्नरेबल है उसके हिसाब से। तो बेस्ट थिंग इज दैट यू कैन डू दैट, कि जूम का ये है कि यूजर फ्रेंडली ज्यादा है, उसका जो क्लैरिटी उसका ज्यादा है कंपेयर टू दी अदर प्लेटफॉर्म। ऑफकोर्स द वेबएक्स इज अ वेरी गुड प्लेटफॉर्म, और वेबएक्स शायद पेड है, और वेबएक्स के अंदर उसका क्या ये सिस्को का एप्लीकेशन है, तो दे आर चार्जिंग, उसका चार्जिंग भी थोड़ा हाई है। तो गूगल मीट इज ऑल्सो द बेस्ट प्लेटफॉर्म यू कैन यूज अगेन, लेकिन
गूगल मीट सर सबसे अच्छा है।
Google Meet is a good platform, मैं बता रहा हूँ, good platform. But see, whenever the security is concerned, मैंने पहले भी बताया, there is nothing like an absolute security in the cyber world, right? तो वो एक आपको रहना है, what is the best practice, आपको best practices करना है, और आपका difference यही है कि आप उसको minimum अच्छी तरह से अलग इस तरह से यूज करेंगे तो क्या है कि वो मिनिमम चांस आपके विक्टिम होने के, तो दैट कैन यू डू ऑनली
जी। नहीं सर, गूगल मीट में भी जो हमारा ईमेल आईडी है वो एक डिफरेंट रखना होगा।
गूगल मेल में भी आप डिफरेंट यानी हाँ जीमेल का ही रखना होगा, लेकिन गूगल मीट में आप अपना ईमेल आईडी कोई भी रख सकते हैं, यानी जो रेगुलर कर रहे हैं उससे अलग ईमेल आईडी आप कोई भी प्लेटफॉर्म पे यूज करिए, दैट इज अ गुड ऑप्शन
जी। सॉरी सर, लेकिन अभी तक जो हम बनाए हैं, जो अभी जूम में हम जो कंटिन्यू कर रहे हैं उसको डिसकंटिन्यू करने के लिए हम क्या करें, उसको अनइंस्टॉल कर दें?
नहीं, अनइंस्टॉल करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है इसमें, ये इंस्टॉल ये तो आप अभी आपको सपोज कि अगर आपको ये मीटिंग में अटेंड करना है, ठीक है, आपका ईमेल आईडी आपने जो बनाया है, तो आपको जो आप अगर ये वेबिनार में आप एंटर हुए हैं तो वहाँ आपको वही ईमेल आईडी देना है जो नया बनाया है, तो दैट वे वो आपका नया ईमेल आईडी से कम्युनिकेट हो जाएगा, फिर आपको पुराना ईमेल आईडी की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ेगी ना। तो दैट वे व्हेनेवर यू आर कनेक्टिंग विद द स्टूडेंट्स आल्सो एज वेल एज द डिफरेंट वेबिनार, यू कैन गो थ्रू विद योर न्यू ईमेल आईडी ओनली।
जी जी, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू।
ओके सर, लेट मी आल्सो क्लेरिफाई, डॉक्टर श्रीवास्तव, nowadays everything is susceptible, everything is doubtful. ऑफलाइन ना यू ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड डॉक्यूमेंट्स, मेनी डॉक्यूमेंट्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आधार कार्ड, पैन कार्ड, एनी ऑफिस, वेरी गुड ट्रेजरी।
जी जी, ओके सर, बट मैंने बीइंग ए एक्सपर्ट, मैंने डॉक्टर चिंतन पाठक, वी वांट टू नो अबाउट समथिंग स्पेशल बिकॉज़ ही इज द एक्सपर्ट ऑफ साइबर सिक्योरिटी, एंड इफ ही से समथिंग आई हैव फेथ।
आई ऑल्सो डू हैव फेथ इन हिम, राइट, एज फार एज इंटरनेट इज कंसर्न ही इज एक्सपर्ट, राइट। इज देयर एनी क्वेश्चन?
जी जी, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू,
थैंक यू, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू। Is there any question from participant side? I don't think that, because you have explained it. It was quite explanatory.
Right.
It was quite illuminating, right? So and compact and concisely you have done it. And Miss, your presentation was pointed, right? You have focused on some areas which are very, you can say, susceptible or viable, all right? So,
sir.
Tanvir sir. Yeah.
Sir, my question.
Please. please. Compact and concise you have done it. And your presentation was pointed, right? Your focus area, which are very, can say, susceptible or viable, all right? So,
sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, we have a question from a YouTube user, Brijesh Dari. He says that my question is, nowadays, each and every webinar and ePDF asks for mobile numbers. Our full name and email are participants. So is it secure to share our full name, mobile number or email ID?
These are some of the mandatory requirement right now, because how can we identify the people, right? So once ever, because it is already, you are putting that name on your certificate also. So if you are not giving your full name, of course, if you want to don't give your full name, so just give your short name also. It is completely fine. It is not but you need to be mentioned over there something, right, for that thing. The thing is that particularly your mobile number. So again, that I say about that, you can do one thing. That if you have a two mobile number, just like an email ID, you need to be put the second mobile number for this kind of activity. So you are securing yourself. Otherwise, say you need to be some mandatory requirement, because these are the communication channel right now available that you need to be fulfilled for that only. And of course, this is an academic purpose only. We are not here for the any kind of right now in the any commercial purposes, right? So again, that it is not. I personally believe that there is nothing wrong in it, but of course, you need to be make sure that. If you have a doubt in your mind, that of course you can share a very, very short detail. If you are not supposed to share your whole name, or maybe you can put a different mobile number which is not basically associated with your different platform, that you can do at yourself, because you are free for that. It is your right also.
Hello.
Please.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you are audible, sir.
Sir, my question is related to nowadays, we have so many accounts and so many email IDs and so many things are there. So we have to manage so many passwords and emails and all that. So can you give some ideas so that we can manage all the passwords? Because everybody is thinking that one or two or three, four password we can... we can give the same password to the each and every account. So how can we manage these passwords? This is my question.
See, password is a very, very complicated means. It is really a very, very tedious part of it to manage, first thing. Now, see, as I mentioned earlier, that if suppose that some line you like very much, if I am telling the one line that I love to share this video. I love to share this video with everyone. So now, how can I make this line as a password, right? Whatever the line you need to be, you like, then if suppose that it is putting in your desktop also, but how can you make this whole line as a password? So you can take the I as a capital, then L as a small, then love as a capital again, that then I love two as a numerical, U as particularly, we cannot say the YOU, but you can do, you take only U only. And another initially letter of the word you can put as a whole as a password. So maybe your password is going to be 8 to 9 characters with the alpha numerical and the special character of this, because and you can use the and of the symbol and two, you can use the numerical two. And again, that is how can you make that a secure password? So no one can guess actually. And again, that at the same time it is also available to in front of you. And you can just easily put all this, remember the password also. So this is some of the techniques that you can use to be remember the password. You can make the different password. And of course, that when you are using the same password in the different platform also, there is not harm, because it is a completely unique password. And no one can exactly, even though in the any software is not going to be crackable. So you can do all these things for the password. And again, you can write also somewhere, because things occur. But again, I'm not suggesting any application. There are a lot of applications that are available to be put your password and just to create also the secure password. But again, I am not suggesting all these things, because they are the application, and again, that application are vulnerable. So again, it's going to be a threat in future also. So you can do in that manner. I hope that I give you an answer.
Is there any
question?
एक्सक्यूज मी सर, एक क्वेश्चन और पूछना, सॉरी दोबारा डिस्टर्ब कर रहा हूँ आपको।
पूछ लीजिए।
सर सर मैंने ना एक थोड़े दिन पहले किसी मैगजीन में पढ़ा था सर, उसमें ये लिखा हुआ था जो आईफोन आ रहे हैं कि उनका डाटा बहुत ज्यादा सिक्योर है नॉर्मल फोन से, नॉर्मल स्मार्टफोन से, ऐसा है कुछ सर?
देखिए मैं पहले दो चीज आपको बताना चाहता हूँ। फर्स्ट थिंग इज आईफोन यानी कि मैक ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इज अ पर्टिकुलरली अ प्राइवेट प्लेटफॉर्म, इट इज बेसिकली डेवलप्ड बाय द आईफोन कंपनी, राइट? तो इट इज अ डिफरेंट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इन अ मोर सिक्योर कंपेयर टू द एंड्रॉइड। एंड्रॉइड इज अ ओपन सोर्स सिस्टम, तो ये ओपन सोर्स सिस्टम का मतलब ये होता है कि ये इजिली अवेलेबल है, इसको आप इजिली उसको नए मॉडिफिकेशन कर सकते हैं। तो इन दैट केस एंड्रॉइड इज वास्टली यूज बिकॉज ऑफ ड्यू टू द एडोबिलिटी एज वेल एज उसको इजिली मॉडिफाई करके वो यूजर फ्रेंडली ज्यादा है, लेकिन उसकी वल्नरेबिलिटी भी इसलिए ज्यादा है क्योंकि ये ओपन प्लेटफॉर्म है, ये ओपन सोर्स प्लेटफॉर्म है। एंड आईफोन इज पर्टिकुलरली अ प्राइवेट प्लेटफॉर्म, तो कंपैरेटिवली एंड्रॉइड से आईफोन की जो सिक्योरिटी है वो कहीं ज्यादा अच्छी है, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है कि वो क्रैक नहीं हो सकती।
मींस यू मे नॉट 100% सिक्योर बट मच मोर सिक्योर देन अदर मोबाइल फोन्स
कंपेयर टू एंड्रॉइड, यू कैन यस ऑफ कोर्स।
ओके थैंक यू सर।
या एनी क्वेश्चन सर? Please unmute sir. Jaswant sir, please unmute yourself.
Is there any question? Sir, on behalf of Government Arts and Commerce College Netrang, because my principal, honorable principal sir is with me government meeting. So okay. This duty is also given to me. Okay. So on behalf of my college, on behalf of my principal, honorable G.R. Parmar sir, and on behalf of my team, as well as on behalf of my participants, we are there. Miss now we have heterogeneous subjects as well as the Miss audience from all over India, right? So on behalf of all, I sincerely thank you, sir. You have provided us an enlightening lecture. You have provided us some education on the cyber world and how to make ourselves safe, how to protect ourselves, how to be alert. इस अलर्ट एंड अवेयर, राइट? वो बोलते हैं ना हिंदी में, सावधानी हटी दुर्घटना घटी, दैट टाइप ऑफ थिंग, राइट? यू हैव डन एंड वी हैव नाउ वी आर वेरी अलर्ट दैट वी शुड नॉट ऐड दिस और वी शुड नॉट, यू कैन से वी शुड नॉट ऐड सो मच एप्स इन अवर मोबाइल एंड वी शुड कंसिडर दैट allow permit things now. We should also think about them. That generally we believe that okay, this thing is okay, download it. Yes, allow and okay. Right? So let us open that app, right? That craziness, that curiosity, right? Now I think that after this lecture that will be stopped in us, that will be prevented in us. And thank you so much. I also would like to thank all the participants from all over India. Thank you a lot, sir, making this event very educative, very grand. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I close this event. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, sir. And you will have that Miss link with you. Secondly, this is also FB Live, right? This is also YouTube Live. So you can also watch it later on. Yes. Is there any query question?
सर मैं आपके साथ एक लिंक शेयर करूंगा, प्लीज शेयर विद द पार्टिसिपेंट्स अबाउट द
रिलेटेड। ओके एंड आई मिस मेनी मेनी पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर आल्सो विशिंग दैट द पीपीटी शुड बी आल्सो शेयर्ड विद देम, सो काइंडली शेयर दैट पीपीटी सो दैट दे कैन गेट सम मोर इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दैट, राइट? सो काइंडली शेयर इट विद मी, आई विल पुट इट ऑन माय एफबी पेज, राइट? थर्डली आई आल्सो मिस थैंक ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर इंडिया. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, it is you that make our event very great and grand. Yeah. So thank you. And fourthly, I also promise you that we are organizing daily. It is our daily habit. We are,
thank you, sir.
We are 24/7 workers. And 7 days, right? You can also meet us on Sunday too. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. 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 Thank you.